Hi friends, welcome to Pathogenesis, where we understand the disease. We have started Leukemia Bite series, where we will have a rapid review of the common leukemias. Also, we have added take-home points at the end of each video. Today, we will be discussing APML, that is acute promyelocytic leukemia. There are four letters A, P, M and L in this leukemia. Let's understand what each letter means. A stands for acute, to signify its short and drastic course and involvement by immature cell, that is blast. P and M make up for promyelocytes and is characterized by accumulation of blasts blocked at promyelocytic stage of differentiation. Leukemia is proliferation of these cells in the bone marrow and bloodstream. A brief overview of myelopoiesis. It begins with myeloblast, progresses to promyelocyte, myelocyte, finally forming a segmented neutrophil. In APML, there is a block at the promyelo to myelo stage, leading to uncontrolled proliferation, that is leukemia. It is classified as M3 under the FAB classification and as AML with recurrent genetic abnormality in the new WHO classification. It is a very distinct type of AML. Why so much importance to APML? Firstly, its clinical manifestations are life-threatening. Up to 80% of patients presenting with bleeding manifestations and DIC. It is characterized by PML-RARA fusion formed due to balanced translocation of chromosome 15 and 17. It has a characteristic and diagnostic morphology and one of the leukemias where blast percentage of 20 is not required for the diagnosis. It has targeted drug therapy with good response rates to ATRA and ATO. Patients have high complete remission rates of up to 90%. In brief, a prompt diagnosis coupled with easily targeted treatment gives excellent prognosis. Whereas, without treatment, patients quickly worsen and may have cerebral or pulmonary bleed, which can ultimately prove fatal. Few basic facts on epidemiology. APML accounts for 10-15% of AML. Although it can occur at any age, it is common in middle-aged adults with equal incidence among males and females. Moving on to the clinical features, we can remember them by a mnemonic, we slap big fat gorillas. We will take the first letter of each word. W stands for weight loss, S and L for splenomegaly and enlarged liver, A for anemia, P for petechiae, B for bruises, F for fever and fatigue, and G for bleeding gums. Petechiae and bruises are the most common symptoms. We are going to discuss in detail about pathogenesis of APML. PML gene is present on chromosome 15 through 24 and codes for PML protein, which is responsible for apoptosis and normal transcription of hematopoietic stem cells. RARA is a gene present on 17 through 21 coding for RARA protein. This blue color box is RARA. It combines with other proteins such as RXR and RARE to form heterodimers. This unit together functions as ligand-dependent switch. Under normal conditions, in the absence of retinoic acid, these heterodimers recruit repressor molecules which silences the transcription. However, in presence of physiological levels of retinoids, these retinoids combine with the RAR heterodimers and release the repressors and recruit co-activators, resulting in acetylation of protein and activation of transcription, causing differentiation of myeloid cells up to the neutrophils. PML-RARA fusion protein not only recruits repressors on RARA, causing transcriptional inhibition, but they also inhibit differentiation of myeloid cells. This fusion also inhibits PML activity, thereby inhibiting apoptosis and giving survival and proliferative advantage to cells. All these genetic events give rise to APML. A quick overview of variants in APML, which can be morphological variants like classical and hypergranular or hypogranular forms. Molecular variants can be variants of translocation 15-17. Breakpoint cluster 1 at intron 6 is the most common variant, followed by breakpoint cluster 3 at intron 3. BCR3 causing microgranular form has a higher incidence of DIC and a higher leukocyte count. There are a few translocations besides 15-17. These include ZBTB16, NUMA, NPM1, FIPIL1 and STAT5B. ZBTB-RARA at 1117 is the most common variant translocation and is resistant to ATRA, as is STAT5B-RARA. APML is diagnosed easily on peripheral blood smear and bone marrow examination. It can have a normal TLC in classical variant or hyperleukocytosis in microgranular variant. An abnormal promyelocyte has nucleus which is irregular, folded or dumbbell shaped, also known as buttock shape or apple core deformity, as seen in this picture. Cells have aur rods which often occur in bundles known as Fagot cells. These two photomicrographs show the morphological variants of APML. Top picture is of classical APML with granules obscuring the nucleus. Microgranular form with less granules but characteristic bilobe nucleus is seen in the bottom picture. Cytochemistry shows bright MPO staining in the form of dense black granules. Flow cytometric evaluation of APML produces a teardrop pattern on CD45 site scatter plots. DR and CD34 are negative. CD13, 33, 117 and MPO are positive. Molecular diagnosis of PML-RARA fusion can be done by cytogenetics and karyotyping, FISH or RT-PCR. Karyotyping sheets show 15-17 translocation. FISH metaphase analysis shows two distinct signals for PML and RARA as red and green respectively, whereas in APML, red and green signal combined together as fusion signal. Treatment goals for APML are to control symptoms and decrease the risk of complications. Oral trans-retinoic acid is a vitamin A derivative and is the cornerstone of treatment. As a part of induction therapy, it induces leukemic promyelocytes to develop into mature cells, that is neutrophils. Let's see how ATRA acts. ATRA binds to RAR-PML complex and recruits co-activators by replacing repressors. This causes acetylation of complex and activation of transcription. Thus, ATRA removes inhibition of differentiation of myeloid cell and also of apoptosis. Other drugs are anthracycline and arsenic trioxide. We will discuss treatment and related complications in later videos. Take home points on today's topic. Most common symptom is bleeding. PML-RARA is characteristic translocation. Flow cytometry plots show 34 and DR negativity with bright MPO positivity. Teardrop pattern is seen on CD45 site scatter plots. Microgranular variant shows breakpoint 3 translocation. ATRA and arsenic form mainstay of the treatment.
Thank you for watching. If you liked our video, please share and also subscribe so that you never miss any of the pathogenesis updates. Pathogenesis, helping you to understand the disease.